about 1 kilo of chicken here. So we're going to add a few ingredients for the marinade, starting with turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon. Chili powder, about 3 to 4 teaspoons. So if you like it spicy, you can add a little extra. 2 teaspoons of coriander powder, garam masala, 1 teaspoon. Salt, 1 teaspoon. Ginger paste, 2 teaspoons. Garlic paste, 2 teaspoons. So I have a cup of curd. Quickly going to just mix it lightly, and then I'm going to pour it over the chicken. Now we're going to mix the marinade into the chicken. Make sure it's all coated well. So you need to marinate this chicken for a minimum of 2 hours before we start cooking. Add 3 tablespoons of ghee, some whole spices, cinnamon, cloves and cardamom, a few bay leaves, 5 small onions sliced and 2 green chilies. You can see the onions are nice and brown. Next, I'm going to add medium-sized tomatoes, chopped. So the onions have become brown, I've added the tomatoes. Next, I'm going to add the chicken. Just make sure it's all combined well. I haven't added any water at this point. So after 5 minutes, when the chicken is no more pink, just add a handful of fresh coriander leaves and a handful of fresh mint leaves. Close and cook for about 15 minutes on low flame. So check for seasoning at this point. Now I'm going to season it with some salt. I've taken about 400 ml of basmati rice, soaked it for 30 minutes and cooked it, adding some whole spices, that is cinnamon, clove, cardamom and bay leaf. So now this is 3/4 cooked and the chicken is also ready. I'm going to add the 3/4 cooked rice to the pot. Just spread it out evenly. Just add a little ghee. Now I've used aluminium foil to seal this pot. If you have chapati dough, you can use that as well. So place a lid on top and cook it in dum for about 30 minutes. Clay pot biryani is ready. Let's check. Oh, that looks amazing. So I'm just gently going to mix it. So there you have this very special clay pot biryani. Let me tell you, the flavors of this biryani is very unique and it's got this lovely smoky earthy flavor to it. So definitely do try and enjoy it with your family. So we're doing the mud pot egg curry. For this, you can take a nice mud pot which is a bit wide. To this, I'm going to add 2 tablespoons of oil, add 1/2 teaspoon of mustard seeds, 1/2 teaspoon of cumin seeds, 1/4 teaspoon fennel. When the mustard seed starts splattering, add 2 onions finely chopped. Next, add 1 green chili and a few curry leaves. Saute the onions till they are nice and brown. I'm adding 1 teaspoon of ginger garlic paste. Next, add 2 small tomatoes finely chopped. Since I'm cooking in the clay pot, it takes a lot of heat, so I'm keeping the flame on high throughout the cooking process. Now I'm going to season it with salt, 1/4 teaspoon turmeric powder, 2 teaspoons chili powder, 1 whole teaspoon of coriander powder. Reduce the flame to a nice low. I'm going to grind a masala now. So we're going to put a few ingredients together and grind it to a nice fine paste. Taking 4 cashew nuts, 1 teaspoon roasted chana dal, 1/2 teaspoon fennel, 3 teaspoons coconut, fresh grated. I've soaked 1/2 teaspoon of poppy seeds in water. So I'm going to add that as well. Add a little water and grind this to a nice fine paste. Now I'm going to add this paste into the tomato onion masala. So make sure it's nice and fine, the masala paste. Reduce the flame to a medium. Add about 3 small cups of water. Season with a little salt. After adding the masala paste, make sure to add a little salt to get the right flavor. Increase the flame to a high and let the gravy come to a boil. I've boiled 5 eggs and kept it aside. When the curry comes to a boil, just make small slits on the egg on all sides and gently place it into the pot. Now I've added the eggs that I have slit. Reduce the flame to a medium, close the pot and cook for about 10 minutes on medium flame. Wow, that looks fantastic. The oil has separated. I'm going to finally garnish it with some fresh coriander leaves. So there you go. You can try this lovely and simple egg curry recipe. You can even try it if you don't have a mud pot. You can make it with any other kadai. So make sure if you're making fish curry to use a nice white pot. I'm going to add about 3 tablespoons of oil. This is gingerly oil. So once the oil is heated up, I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of mustard seeds, 1/4 teaspoon of fenugreek, 1/2 teaspoon of peppercorns. So once the mustard seeds start splattering, so I have about 15 shallots that have been sliced. You can see it's thinly sliced. Next, add 2 green chilies. They're slit. You can see I'm adding those. Now you've got to brown these onions to a nice, lovely golden brown color. 3 cloves of garlic that have been roughly pounded. 1 whole teaspoon of ginger garlic paste. Once the raw smell of the ginger garlic paste goes, 4 small tomatoes, you can see, finely chopped. I'm going to add these. As the tomatoes are getting mushy, add salt. Adding 1 teaspoon of salt now. 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder. Add 3 whole heaped teaspoons of chili powder. Next, add 1 whole teaspoon of coriander powder. You can see the tomatoes are mashed very nicely. Next, I'm going to add 1 cup of tamarind puree. It's a nice thick puree, so reduce the flame. So next, I'm going to add water and bring this curry to a boil. Keep the flame on medium. I need to at least add about 1.5 cups of water and bring this curry to a nice boil. And let it boil till the oil separates. You can close the pot now. So the curry has come to a nice boil here, you can see. You need to let it boil for about 7 minutes till the raw smell goes. Before you add the fish, make sure to check for seasoning, and if you need a little salt, you can add at this point. Now I have sear fish, that is vanjaram, cut into small pieces. I have about 12 pieces here. You can use bigger chunks if you like, or if you have, just gently start dropping the fish pieces into the curry. So I'm just going to gently stir it without using the spatula because I don't want to break the pieces of fish. All the pieces are nicely immersed in the gravy. Now once you've added the fish, finally add a nice handful of curry leaves. Now you can add these in the beginning or at the end. They give a lovely flavor to the dish, and especially any typical South Indian dishes, we use a lot of curry leaves. Keep the flame on medium. So close the pot and cook for about 5 to 7 minutes. The fish curries come to a lovely boil. You can see, so once it starts boiling, just turn off the stove. So there's something important that you should remember while cooking fish. The cooking time for fish takes very less. It takes only about 7 to 10 minutes max if they're big pieces. So you don't want to overcook them. They can become very hard and rubbery. You can get a copy of our first edition of the home cooking book on 21 Flames.